Hey everyone, what's going on? Claudio Zavala Jr. here. Thank you so much for stopping by and checking out this video. For those of you out there that are watching this and are looking to getting into editing videos, creating videos to share here on YouTube or any other platform, you're in luck because today I'm going to show you a really cool app that you can use not only on your desktop, but also on your mobile phones. This app is called Adobe Premiere Rush. I'm not gonna go through in finite detail. I have a link up here if you wanna check out this video where I go through a full step-by-step tutorial. So let's go ahead and get started here. Okay, I'm going to launch Adobe Premiere Rush. You'll see your projects if you have several here. What you'll want to do is tap on the plus sign at the bottom to add any media clips. Choose add media to select videos or photos that you have on your device. In this case, I'm going to go to videos and look for some video clips from a project some time ago here. I'm going to pick these here. You can pick as many as you want. This one is from a Dungeons and Dragons session. I'm going to call it D&D. If I choose sync with Creative Cloud, it'll save it to the cloud, and then I can go ahead and edit on any device that I want that has Premiere Rush installed. I'm going to tap on create and begin editing this little short video. And as you can see, I can scrub through the videos. And what I'll do here is I'm gonna zoom into the video clips here. As you see, as if I tap each clip, I'm given the option to do several things. I can trim this video clip by clicking and dragging in, or if I click on it and move my scrub line, and then at the bottom I'm going to tap on the scissors and it will cut that clip. I can do several things. I can move it somewhere else or just tap on the trash can to get rid of it. Let's go ahead and trim this one as well. Just gonna drag this one in. So now I've got four clips here. The next thing I'll want to do is add some titles here. So I have the ability to add titles, but before I do that, I want to direct you to that icon on the lower left. It's got a vertical and a series of horizontal lines. When I tap on that, I'm able to see all the different layers I can add. I can have four total image, text, or video layers. And then I have three audio layers, either for audio tracks like music or a voice track like a narration. Let's go ahead here and choose titles, and I can have these different motion text or motion graphics, and I'm going to choose this one here that says trend blocky titles and drag it to this layer. And if you can see, as I scroll through, you'll see that text there. Now, I'm going to click and drag that to make it shorter, but also I'm going to move that to the front so that it introduces my video. Now, with the text clip selected, I'm going to come up here and tap on the word blocky, double tap there, and put the and sign. Do the same with trend. Call this dungeons. Let's spell that correctly. Dungeons, and then go to titles and change that to dragons. Now, what I'll do here is tap on that and then go back to titles at the bottom, and then I have the option to edit that. So now I can see there I have dragons, dungeons, and then and. Let me open that arrow and then resize this. Dragons, have to make sure and select that whole text. Let's shift the baseline up. And now we'll do the same to dungeons. We're going to make that smaller. Leave it where it is and then select and. And we're going to make that smaller, shift it down. Boom, and we're all set here. So now if I scrub through, boom, look at that. Pretty cool. So now if I want to, I could add some more text. Let's do a title here, and let's do like a call out. We're gonna move this here. And then if I want to, I can click in that whole thing and move it. Bring something to attention. We're gonna call this stuffed animal because I have no idea what that's called and my son will be disappointed in me, but that's all right. And then it fades in, it fades out. Now, talking about fading in and out, I'm going to add some transitions here and then just tap on cross dissolve. And then if I want to, I can add a built-in preset. So if you notice how the colors change for that. So I'll go and choose each one. Let's do the same one for each clip. And one more. Color it up. So there, we are in business. Last thing I'll do is I'm going to mute this entire track. You see that audio just went from blue to gray. And then I'm going to add media, go to audio, then to a soundtrack that's built in to Rush. I can also bring in royalty-free music. I'm gonna go ahead and tap add, and boom. Now we have audio here, music, and if I scroll through here, we're going to trim it because that audio track is way longer. Boom. Now we're all set. And lastly, what I'll do is tap on the share button. So we'll click on export and let Adobe Rush do its magic. Once the video is rendered, it's been saved to my camera roll. And then I have the option here to log into any one of these social media platforms, tap on it, sign in. And then if I choose to publish, I'm able to add description and all the extra information. So for this example, I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to go ahead and cancel. But you can see there that you have that option to immediately share from right here within Adobe Rush. All right, there you have a quick run through of Adobe Premiere Rush. Adding videos that were on my phone, trimming them, muting the track, adding some titles, and then dipping to black, adding a soundtrack, trimming that track, and then export rendering right on my phone. And if I want to log into different social media platforms and share immediately from my phone without ever having to touch the computer in this case. Now, as I mentioned earlier, you can edit on your computer. You just download Adobe Premiere Rush. If you want to start on your phone and finish on your computer, you can easily do that and vice versa. It's a great, great tool, especially if you're on the go. If you need to do all your editing on your phone or iPad, boom, you have that option. So what do you think? Is Adobe Premiere Rush something that you might use? Please let me know by adding some of your comments in the comment section below. And let me know what you thought about this video. Give it a thumbs up by clicking on that like button down there. And if you haven't done so, do subscribe to the channel. And don't forget to turn on the notifications so that you can check out my next coming videos. Until next time, peace. I'm out.